So, frankly, I have no idea what it was we were just doing. Probably something important. I really seem to recall that we were doing something quite crucial. Oh! We were, in fact, bringing back what's his name's
What can I
key,
do for you, my friend?
or whatever it is. Strange how a moment in a new home can feel like, I don't know, a week or more. Not that I'm particularly keen on calling that place home. Far more likely, we'll be leaving here shortly.
Have you
Oh.
ever tried bear bite?
Hello.
I didn't like it. It started to make me a little sore after a while.
Well, Dooley.
What's with the funny face?
I've
Ever
got
stop for a
your
horse riding?
fortune here.
Yes, what about it?
I found your brother's chest.
You did? What was in it?
A warning. A warning not to trust the Jarl. And the key to his locked room.
A key? Harriput left me a key. I'm confused. It was supposed to be something valuable. But it's just a key. What do we do with the key?
I'm going to see what the Jarl's hiding in this room.
Oh, all right. Maybe there's a treasure in there. A big pile of gold coins and gemstones. Maybe you could even share some of it with me.
Dooley, I wouldn't share it with you. I'd give it to you entirely. Your brother, he left you this treasure. It's yours, the way I see it. So, the Jarl killed Dooley's brother for knowing what's in his secret room. I'm curious to find out the same. But while we're here, I'd like to check one or two other things out. Because as I recall, this caved in the future when we were here last. So perhaps we'll learn something from exploring it currently. So, this immaculate dwarven armor is here on someone's body. And that other guy is wandering around the town with the rest of it. Oh, that's bad.
I don't like the idea of crouching down behind you. If you dare let one go, then you could forget me helping you. Why am I even talking?
Sure, Sophie. Okay, so. Which chance to heal, at the very least. What precisely am I wearing? Yes, the helmet'll certainly help. If we can get it all. So, we'll need the rest of it. Which means we need to remember who it is we're supposed to be talking to. Let's see. Tavern. Oh. We could go into the tavern. We were invited to do something unsavory, if I remember correctly.
Oh, I'm so glad you decided to come see me. What can I do for you, sweet thing?
Hi.
Oh, it's you. Hello again.
What's your story?
You want to hear about little old me? Aren't you adorable? But wouldn't you rather hear what I know about everyone else around here? Go on. Ask me.
Sure. First of all, I should just ask, do you know of a way out of here?
Only one way out of this city, and that's through the bottom of a mug of moonshine, if you get me. Solve all your problems. At least for a while. But then again, some folks will overdo it. Ulrin, the Dunmer fellow, can't miss him, hit the drinks pretty hard after his wife, Maisie, disappeared. Just sits there, night after night. Poor guy.
Wish
I knew
sad.
What happened to her. Caught lots of people talking, but nobody seems to know anything. Odd.
What have you got for sale?
See anything you like?
Not particularly. And you've got little to no gold of your own. Any rumors you've heard?
There's something creepy about Marius up in the Citadel. Plus, he never comes down to the tavern. And you just can't trust a man who doesn't drink.
Sure.
Oh, so soon? Well, you know where to find me, honey.
She really did imply she had some business with us when we first got to town, didn't she? I suppose she's just a good saleswoman.
I do love causing a stir. Once
yes,
I started singing at the top
I'm
of
aware.
My voice, someone told me to stop shouting. Then I replied,
to
you look dragonborn or like one of those
unlit
guys who live on the mountaintop
furnaces. Could always be some sort of secret puzzle. You'd be shocked how many puzzles a pirate runs across. Seems every port you roll into, there's some ruin or another, with a secret puzzle that'll lead to some treasure. Though I must say, on the Abyssian, the Dunmer, or not Dunmer, Dwemer, whatever, the Dwarven ruins are a little bit rarer. Okay, so, we're looking for the expert person. Wish I could remember her name. Okay, let's try one more time. Precus. No. Find a ring. Talk to someone about a ring. Find a way into the palace. Okay, so not Brol the scholar, but his apprentice, something or other. Do you think it's Lukey? I suppose it could be.
Hi there.
Hi. What have you got for sale?
Just a small selection of potions. Ingredients are in short supply here. Happy to buy yours if you have any.
I would, but you're...
Fine, just walk away. Hi there.
So, you have some nice books here. Let's see if your door down here is unlocked.
Hi there.
Seems not. Someone must have the key, though. That would certainly be convenient. Okay. Let's see if anyone up here is in fact the person we're looking for. Degland doesn't sound right. Ratasia? Rastasia? Nah, whoever. Could be the right person. If they were home. Oh, good. Forsworn. So... That's pretty awful. You'd think that if you were to... Ooh. Ooh. That's... pretty threatening.
If I found out his wife was Dragonborn, he wouldn't be best pleased. Men already constantly complain about being shouted at by their wives.
Not really that funny.
Shouting at her husband?
Hi.
Oh, it's you.
Oh.
Hello again. You just thought you'd follow me home like a lost puppy, did you?
No.
Get lost. Hey, stupid.
Sure, I'll leave. Okay. Really didn't plan that very well, did I? I really wish I remembered the woman's name who we were looking for. So... coffins, as they were in the future. No way up and over. Some gloves there that I'd very much like. But how precisely would we get them? There is always the old bucket trick if we need to. But I think, perhaps, we can find a better way. willing to bet that if we go through the Jarl's secret storage room, we'll find what it is we need. Though I would very much like to find the scholar we're looking for, whose name I really can't remember. Ismar. No, she was the farmer, I think. Gulvar sounds masculine. Oh, hey. Reward notice. Okay. Man wants his wife back, that's understandable. I think I recall that she... Is this the person? Oh, someone has a will. So, oh, this was the person who was...
Oh, you owe me a serious foot rub for all the walking you've made me do?
Sure.
What do you mean it's my fault? Yes, okay, I may have agreed to it, but... whatever, you still owe me a foot rub?
You certainly, inferred a lot from my silence there. Next time I'll try to remember exactly what it is you're going to say, and, say it first. Okay, you.
You there. Come over here.
Do you need any help?
I'm beyond help. The potions do nothing. And I don't have much time. I just need to tell you something.
What would you like to tell me?
Stendar. He plants these images in my head. He shows me secrets. Made me come here.
Sure. I've heard worse reasons. What did you see?
Something terrifying. Deep in the earth beneath the city. Powerful. And evil. I went down into the tunnels to destroy it. But the energy... it seeps into your bones. Please. Please, you must find a way to get down there. And finish what
Oh. Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay, first, we will need these. And I'm fairly sure he did leave them to us. Or someone like us. Okay. Oh. Okay, here's the bargain we're going to strike. It is appropriate. To strip a body before you lay it in rest to its resting place. Okay, so what we're gonna do is take his things, which are really quite valuable, but...
What's on your mind?
We'll lay him to his rest, or some approximation thereof. It's a little bizarre that he doesn't seem to own all his things. So, glad we saw him before, you know, that happened. beacon, Miranda.
You know what we should do? We should get drunk and have a big sing song. No, a naked sing song.
No.
Yes, that would be fun.
Not appropriate at the time. The current moment. You know, it. No, just no. Okay. Maybe this woman we're looking for lives in the castle. We at least need to go there to try and see what's going on with the assassin, who we need to say was about to be assassinated, and the Jarl's secret room, which is still something of a mystery. Are you coming? Okay, you'll catch up. So, oh, this could be her.
Not here. He can hear us.
Oh, sure. This is the evil son of a bitch who lives with her. Okay. We can assassinate him a little later. Oh, good. Skooma user. Easy enough to do. And let's see if we can't find. Nope, not him. Perhaps
Hello.
You.
Hello there.
No, not you. Must be someone else who told us all about the armor that the guy had that we're going to get. Okay. So, this was the assassin, but it seems he's not here at the moment, and he has a letter telling him he needs to run. Good to know. Maybe he did. Maybe he's waiting in the wings and is going to be, you know, conveniently dead. Or murdered, and thus bringing about the doom to all of us. There are actually quite a lot of possibilities here, and many of them are quite unpleasant for us and others.
By the Eight! I hear you took on a band of marauders by yourself, you buffoon! Next time, come and get me. I'll show them what for.
No, I don't rightly think I will. So, this is the Skooma addict. And up here is the kitchen.
Oh,
do not give the Skooma addict Skooma. Here's somebody or other.
Like an invasion all on your own. That's fine work.
Sure. Oh, I remember now. This is the guy who occasionally does work. Also, sad story about his wife
working
missing
hard.
Or something. And if we come up here, we'll reach the third floor, because I've been keeping track. Pretty sure this will be the third floor. Okay, we have the Jarl's secret room that we will enter shortly, the baths, which are leaking. generally a bad sign, a bucket. But we'd have to steal it. And stealing apparently brings the doom down on all of us. You are the Jarl's daughter.
Told me what you did to those lutens. He says you're dangerous and I should avoid you. I think we're going to be good friends.
Sure. Seems likely. Jarl's balcony, Jarl himself, don't care for the man. So, if we come over here, and quickly ask for Kinnereth's blessing. Okay. Let's test to see what's in here. Nothing worth stealing. Ooh. Okay. There is a chained person here. A chained woman.
Oh, gods, not again! Please don't hurt me!
I'm not gonna hurt you.
Thank the gods!
What's wrong?
You have to let me down before that monster comes back!
Okay, wait. I have some questions first.
Okay, but please hurry!
Who are you?
Maisie. I lived down in the city with my husband Ulrin until a few months ago when that animal Metallus tricked me into coming here. He keeps me here as a... Oh gods, I can't. You have to let me down, please. I've never done anything to deserve this.
Isn't this against the dwarves' law?
Of course it is. But I think the dwarves are blind to whatever happens in this room. You can see the dwarven bust over there got broken somehow.
So... this is complicated. If I let you go, what'll you do?
I'm going to kill that monster who calls himself Jarl. I'll scratch out his eyes with my bare hands if I have to.
So, if I found your necklace in an underground tunnel, what would that mean?
That sounds like the sort of thing Metallus would do. Make it look like I was dead so Ulrin would stop looking for me. That bastard!
Okay, so that's all the questions I had.
Oh, Maisie.
No.
I lived down in the... He keeps
that's it.
Me here
no,
as
all
a...
the questions
so
I had.
You'll let me go then?
This is... complicated. Because here's the thing. If I let you go, you'll go and break the dwarves' law. Probably we all die in fire. I may get to come back, which would be a plus. I may even get to try again. You know, for once, let's do the right thing. Sure, and I'll just know not to come and save you next time if things go wrong.
Thank you. He'll be here any moment, so be quiet and follow my lead.
A bucket. So, what's gonna happen here?
Be reasonable. If you attack me in here, you'll break the dwarf's law and kill us all!
Don't think I've ever
What a mage. Oh. Oh. So... that went poorly.
Hi there. You gave me a bit of a fright. I thought I was in here alone.
So, you're Altrius, then. Your sister asked me to come in and find you.
Well, that's a relief. Say, I didn't catch your name.
Vorik is the name.
Really? That's strange. I was just reading an old journal I found here. It was burnt, but the last entry mentioned someone with the same name.
What did it say?
It described an event about 7 years ago. Someone with your name appeared in the city out of the lake house, led some kind of uprising against a tyrannical Jarl, breaking an ancient law, and triggering some kind of catastrophe. It said most of the city folk were evacuated, and the stranger disappeared in a flash of light.
Sure. That was me.
I'm not sure I understand.
When I arrive... it's complicated.
I'm sorry. Come again.
Here. I mean, you killed yourself, and there was a time travel thing.
Let me see that.
Gods. This is my handwriting. I have spent a lifetime in this place, going around and around in circles.
This is horrible. But I don't understand how I could have written it.
It was written by a different version of you. I changed the past and, you know, saved you.
I'm not sure I understand.
When I killed the Jarl, I stopped him from opening his time portal. No time portal, no you going back in time in a never-ending loop.
So, you're saying, because you stopped a time portal from being opened, I never went through it. And that's why I don't remember any of this.
Sure.
I guess you saved my life then. And freed most of the people in the process.
Most.
I suppose I should thank you.
Not all.
Even though I don't remember anything. It's just... I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but it seems a shame the city had to be destroyed. Imagine if this place could have been saved.
Would have been better, yeah.
I've been ready to get out of here from the moment I set foot in this place.
So, they made a crack in the bathroom wall. Probably a way to escape.
Lead the way.
Here's the thing, though. You're right. What you said about saving them all. It would be preferable, wouldn't it? And I think I know a way we can do it. Oh, poor woman. I'm so sorry. I'll get you out of this. Eventually. Oh, I'll also take these things. Not that it actually matters, because... Kinnereth, forgive me. Well... not forgive me. Yes. Yes. Kinnereth, forgive me for not saving her immediately. The power of Kinnereth can send us through time. Or, it might not be Kinnereth. I'm still not sure about that. Could be, the other guy. Akatosh. Okay. Anyway. Time travel is fun. And by fun, I mean... kind of a bigger burden than I had hoped for. Gotta save everyone, make sure everything happens perfectly. Is this a book I've read before? I have. So, Jarl.
Hello again, my friend. Any word about the matter we discussed?
Sure. Could you clarify something for me first?
Of course. What do you want me to clarify?
No.
I'll talk to you soon, I hope.
Sabercats and Kajita sound
sure.
Related?
That sick fuck. Okay. We need to find the son of a bitch who... Okay.
People get a little touchy when I say that.
Okay. Madam, we're coming for you shortly. We could lure the Jarl in to where there isn't actually, guardian or whatever. But... Ooh. Downstairs, where we get to see some domestic abuse. Oh, are you the person we need, though?
I hear you defended the city from attackers. Well, aren't you making friends quickly?
Hi.
Hello, dear.
Who are you?
Oh, my. It's very nice of you to take an interest in my life, dear. But you don't need to humor an old woman.
Sure. Not humoring you, though. Really need to know.
Really? Well, you're the first person in the city to say that. Well, let's see. These days, I mostly just sweep the streets here, keep them clean. Cleanliness is next to godliness, or so they say. It's not very inspiring, as you can imagine, but the alternative is to wind up like poor Dooley.
Well, I know what you mean.
Well, anyway, that's about all there is about me to tell, I'm afraid. I'm not very interesting.
I'm sure there's more than that.
Well, the most important thing in my life is prayer. So let me ask you, have you found room in your heart for Mara, the Mother Goddess?
Mara's not really my deal. I'm more a Kinnereth worshipper myself. And I have other people I need to talk to.
Yes, of course, dear. Don't worry, I get that reaction a lot. Perhaps I'll see you later.
Sure. Bet if we were wearing an amulet of Mara, she'd treat us a little different. But the only one I know of, we'd have to steal from what's-her-name. Jormund? Don't care. Want to see the domestic abuse, so that we can potentially beat a guy. Actually, let's just threaten him here and now.
What is it?
Who are you?
I'm sorry, what's my story? What an oblivion is your story? How dare you come in here like you own the place and expect me to explain myself to you?
Oh, as far as I'm concerned, I do own the place. Now tell me.
I beg your pardon. Did you just threaten to hurt me? Is that supposed to make me frightened of you? Let me explain something to you, peasant. Cut a single hair on my beard. Cast a single spell. Fire a single arrow, and the dwarves' lore means you're dead.
For the moment.
Got it? You might have been somebody important in your old life, but down here, you're no one. Here, I own you, and there's nothing you can do about it.
There's plenty I can do about it. I might just murder you.
You wouldn't dare. Now get out of here before you embarrass yourself.
Actually,
get away from me, peasant. I don't want anyone seeing us together.
The many shall suffer for the sins of the one.
That's the last of them.
Sure. Heard that. And all. but she annoyed me quite a bit. So, maybe we'll just do this loop again. Actually, I could just murder the man again. Hi. Suppose we're supposed to follow him. Lovely. So, through Kinnereth's grace, this dude doesn't die immediately, so we can take the portal and try again. Hopefully, keeping all of the progress we've made. Oh. Hey. Looks like the doom is, in fact, just a bunch of these fuckers. Oh, they look pretty powerful. So, let's just run past them as commanded. And hi. Use the portal again. Ooh.
You must stop this from happening. My letter.
Oh, I love a challenge. I guess you'll have to do that.
Okay. Take your really valuable stuff. Because, frankly, why not? And then go through your portal. So. Here's a question. Do we still have all the things we got last time? Like, for example, yes. Ha! I've solved a problem I didn't even know we had.
You there? Where did you come from?
We've had this conversation before.
I've never met you.
You're gonna offer to escort me to see the Jarl.
You're right. I was. How could you have possibly known that?
Don't worry about it. I'm a time traveler. Now if you'll excuse me.
Is that some kind of sorcerer? Well... I don't want any trouble. Let me get out of your way. Let's forget this happened, shall we?
Thank you kindly. Now, I'm looking for a few people.
Welcome, love.
I'm looking for you.
Sweet.
Hello.
New in town, huh? About go and see the Jarl before you start any trouble.
About that armor you have.
What about it?
I need it to complete the set.
Not my problem.
I'd like to buy it
it's
from you.
It's not for sale.
Well, then, I want it.
Oh, well, in that case, you still can't have it. Let me be clear. The only way you'll get this armor is if you peel it from my corpse.
Sure, that can be arranged.
Not going to happen, maggot. Because you know, and I know, that the first blow that gets landed is going to get us all killed. You're not that stupid.
Unfortunately, it won't get all of us killed. Just you. And you'll come back too. So, at least there's that. Oh boy. That. Nope, didn't quite kill me. Yet. I need that armor. Okay. Now, I need that guy to move out of the way. Because I need that armor. And apparently I need to put something back because now I've got too much weight. Pretty sure. Oof. Okay. So, it's going to have to be... No. I want to wear that. I want to store this. Oh. Store that. Now we're good. Follow the Jarl, go back in time again, take this armor. Now we just need to find a way to get the gloves. Okay. So. Lydia, Sophia. Sophia, glad you made it. Where's Lydia?
You must stop this.
Good. Lydia.
Happening.
Glad you made it. Let's take this. That'll do. You know.
You are an abomination. Killing you would be the kindest thing to do.
No, I'm not. Okay, so let's go through the door. Back through time again. So, here's what we've learned. For an unsavory character, this could be very profitable. Because every person here has a treasure or two that we could take and keep each time we go back. But I suppose they'd be suffering for it, wouldn't they? Most of them I don't might. Right care about.
You there? Where did you come from?
Nope.
What
We've had this conversation before.
I've never met you.
Yes. I'm a time traveler. We're all good.
Some kind of sorcerer? Well, I don't
so,
want any trouble. Let me get out of the way.
Here's what we need. So, let's just make sure. You're Yismar, right?
Welcome, love.
Okay. Useless person, or at least not useful to me at the moment. You there.
Welcome.
Miranda.
We'll talk more once you've spoken with the Jarl.
What's your story?
Oh, there's not much to tell. My husband Tabik runs the clothing store in town. You should stop by. I'm sure you'll leave looking much better. Not that you don't look good now, I mean.
Sure.
It's just,
don't care.
You know, nice clothes.
We see you with the tavern tonight.
Absolutely not.
Same as always. Goodbye, Restacia. And please, stay out of trouble.
Okay, roll. Hi. Found some immaculate dwarven armor.
Yes. Most dwarven armor you see these days is quite badly worn. But this piece is still perfect. After thousands of years, it also seems to have some magical properties. It should protect you from the harmful energy down in the tunnels below the city. It all but killed Brandis when he went down there, but he didn't have a full set. If you can get down there safely, let me know what you discover.
Sure. I'll be going.
Very well. Come back if you think of any questions about something you discover.
Sweetheart, we'll have plenty of time to get to know each other once you've spoken with the Jarl.
Okay, so everyone wants me to talk to the Jarl, which I really don't want to do, because he seems like a right prick. In fact, we know he's a right prick.
We can talk, but be quick. Domitus could be back any second.
Hi. Why can't you talk to me in front of Domitus?
Because he's incredibly nasty when he gets angry, and if he saw us speaking, he'd be furious.
Sure. Sure. Don't much care. Killed the man already once. Okay. This is the healer woman, correct? Hi.
Hi there.
Do you know a way out of here?
There isn't one. This place is like a firefly trap. One way in, no way out. Could be worse, though. You could be living in bloody Skyrim.
Sure. Bye.
Fine. Just walk away.
Okay, so there must be a way to go over this gate here. Because here's the thing. The very last. Okay, we're gonna look in here. Because maybe... there's a path through here. Okay. Here's a prayer. Leave things to Dooley. Care for him. Yeah. It's a fucking abomination that they treat him so poorly as it is. Okay, so... no secret path as far as I can tell. We will need to get through here, though. Perhaps we can billygoat our way across the side? Close, close. I don't love our chances. So, can we go this way? No. Not really. Hopefully we can get back. And yes, indeed, we can. So. In order to get under the city, we either have to break into every individual's house and check their basement and their possessions to see if we can't find a way down. Or we have to find a way through here. When, as far as I can tell... there is neither key... close this gate. And you open it. Okay, so we need this gate here to open. Or we need another way through. Because we need those gloves right there. Can see them. Clear as day. Now I know I can effectively overcome this obstacle. Somehow. Okay, so here's my first try. And no. So we can't just light them. Okay.
Never work on a
check every coffin.
Full of tools and hose. Those hose are real to use. Never again. I do an honest work.
There's a skull. Okay. Didn't really want to take the skull, but could be worse. So, no hidden lever as far as I can tell. Close that gate, and while it's closed, we come over here. Still nothing. Probably because there's this huge bar here that is preventing our way forward. As far as I can tell, there's no side passage. This is fucking frustrating. Especially since I know I could end this all. I could probably even do it while saving everyone in the town by luring the stupid fucking Jarl into his secret torture room. But if I did that, I would never solve this fucking mystery. And there aren't a lot of things that mean more to me than people's lives. It might be shocking to you that a pirate would think that, but treasure is one of the things that means more to me than most people's lives. Not their suffering, but certainly their lives. Though to be fair, I've taken from many a man without killing them. If necessary, I kill. But if necessary, or if unnecessary, I don't. Anyway, okay. Disowned, blah blah blah. Skeever killed someone's thing. Huh. Okay, Degland, whoever that is a right psychopath. Good to know. Do we know anything about Degland? Except that apparently he's wealthy. Okay. So, let's consult our text. Can't fucking believe I'm consulting a text to figure out who Degland is. So, Haribal apparently found the key. That's fine. That's the dead brother. We already have that key. Domitus is the successor. That's bizarre. Ulrin Maisie. Okay. Sure. Delgan. Manage the homewares store. Okay. So, ancient evil under the city. Marius, we have to go back to him and tell him he's the dude. Perhaps we can take it differently this time. Okay, so Degland, the sociopath, keeps the home goods store. Don't remember Luki. Okay,
The guys in Skyrim are a miserable bunch.
Wolves,
bandits, and a lot worse all day, and they complain about a single arrow in the knee.
Hi. You don't even have the key to your own house. That's always nice. Okay. So, we've been here before. Have we been here before? This is our chambers. Yes, we have. Have we been to this man's chambers?
Ah, newcomer. You should head on up to the Citadel. Make yourself known to the Jarl.
Okay, conjuration book. I will.
Newcomer.
Yes. Sure.
You should head on up to the Citadel.
Oh.
Make yourself known to the Jarl.
I will. Eventually. Hey, Pirate King of the Abyssian. Velik Sane. Fucking poser. Poke your eyes, lad, pour you. Blah, blah. Yeah, no. They've got it wrong. Okay. No. They've just transliterated it wrong. It's not Velik, it's Vorik. Noose, plank, boards, it's crossing sword. No, certainly me, Pirate King of the Abyssian. Yeah, Captain Vorik. I mean, there's no Sane. I don't tell people my last name, but.
Newcomer.
Okay, so.
You
that's
head on up to the
disturbing.
City. make yourself known to
the pig children. Orcs. Oh, okay. So just racism. Good to know. Okay. I'm also going to start checking everyone to see if they have the key.
Now, there's no need to steal from me. I'll happily share. Ah, newcomer.
Sure.
Head on up to the Citadel.
Just checking to see who has the key to downstairs. Hi. Okay.
We'll talk more once you've spoken with the Jarl.
Do I really need to go and talk to that man?
Oh, I remember the first time I...
Oh, key.
At the Jarl. I was so... nervous.
The many shall suffer for the sins of the one.
Okay. I remember now. Not allowed to steal. Not allowed to steal. So. What just happened? What? Okay, something went slightly wrong there. Kinnereth, what's going on? This is, not actually how... Okay. Let's try this again. Kinnereth. Bring me back.
Ah, newcomer.
Okay, so. I'm about to be extremely disappointed. Okay. Where's Altrius? Because I'm also quite curious what just happened here. Okay. You. Hi. Nope. Well. Don't be too fast. Really? Hey.
That's strange.
So, here's the thing.
About 7 years ago, said hardly a word to anyone. Walked up to the Jarl and murdered him, breaking some kind of ancient law. It said this triggered a horrific event which killed everyone in the city.
So,
while the stranger just disappeared.
Okay.
In a flash of light.
So, something's gone very wrong. Something about Kinnereth's ability to send me back in time. And again, could be Akatosh. Anyway, Kinnereth's ability to send me back.
You know, because you might fall and hurt yourself.
Interfering with the Jarl's spell. What I'd really like... Perhaps now I can go back, not have the whole bad thing happen. Okay, so if we do that, if we run over here, ugh. Okay. So clearly this is not working. Okay, why are you sweeping, Sophie? Okay. Let's try something a little bit more extreme. Kinnereth, help me.